Dear students, today we will discuss about Grayback normal form. So, in last class we discussed about CNF, how we are going to convert the given context-free grammar into CNF. Today we discuss about how we can convert the given context-free grammar into Grayback normal form. Generally, if the production rule, which is in these two formats, then that grammar may call it as it is in Grayback normal form. So every production rule in grammar should be non-terminal tends to single terminal and string of non-terminals. And another format is non-terminal tends to single terminal. It is saying that in grammar, every production rule in right hand side should start with a single terminal. And then after, it may contain string of non-terminals. It should not contain more than single terminal, and there should follow string of non-terminals. So, if the grammar is in this format, then we say that it is following Grayback normal form. So, this is about Grayback normal form. Now, we discuss about how to convert the given context-free grammar into Grayback normal form. The process for conversion of a context-free grammar into GNF is, the first step is we need to convert the grammar into CNF, Chomsky normal form. So if the given grammar is not in CNF, then convert it into CNF. The first step, we need to check that whether the grammar is in CNF or not, whether it is in Chomsky normal form or not. If it is not, then you need to convert that grammar into CNF. Mostly, they will provide the grammars which are in CNF format only. If not, then we need to convert it. And how to convert the grammar into CNF, we discussed in previous class. Then after, we need to check that if the grammar exists left recursion, then eliminate it. So we need to check that whether the grammar is having any left recursion. What is meant by left recursion? That we'll discuss first, then after we go with conversion. Okay, we'll discuss later, means next slide we'll discuss. And third one is, if the grammar convert the given production rule into GNF form, if any production rule in the grammar is not in the given format. So first we go with first step, and we'll check that whether it is in CNF or not. If it is okay, then go with second step. Is it the grammar contain any left recursion? So if both are not happening, then we go with third one. We'll check that every production rule is following the rule of GNF or not, Grayback normal form or not. Means every production should be in the format like non-terminal tends to a single terminal, or non-terminal tends to single terminal and the combination of non-terminals. If it is having all the things, then we say that the grammar is in Grayback normal form. First, we discuss about what is meant by left recursion. Then we go with one example. Generally, we people know what is meant by recursion. Recursion is nothing but calling by itself. So, A production of a grammar is said to have left recursion if the leftmost variable of its RHS is same as variable of its LHS. So, a production of a grammar is said to have left recursion if the leftmost variable of its RHS is same as variable of its LHS. So, if left hand side and right hand side of leftmost element is having same, then we say that it is left recursion. So, a grammar containing a production having left recursion is called as left recursive grammar. For example, if I say that A tends to capital A small a. When you observe here, this is LHS and this is RHS. So, both are having same non-terminals. Then we call it as the grammar is having left recursion problem. So, why we should consider this one? Means, if I substitute, for example, assume it, we are having some another production rule like this. So, if I want to substitute A in production B, simply we say that B tends to A, B. So, again, if I want to substitute this one with another one, again it will comes to B tends to A, B, A, B. Again, it is repeated. Means, here, repetition is going on. We don't get the final answer here. So, to avoid that one, we need to remove that left recursion. Now, we discuss about how to remove left recursion in the given grammar. Simply, there is one formula is there. With the help of that formula, we can remove the left recursion. So, now we discuss about how to eliminate left recursion. Left recursion is eliminated by converting the grammar into a right recursive grammar. So, we are having left recursive grammar and right recursive grammar. So, if we converted the left recursive grammar into right recursive grammar, then we can eliminate left recursion. Assume it, we are having one production rule which is in this format. A tends to A alpha or beta. So, if it is in that case, we say that it is left recursive grammar. And you should keep in mind that beta does not begin with an A. When you are considering someone as beta, should not begin with A. For example, assume it, I took one production rule like A tends to A, B, slash B. If I take this production rule, here A tends to, this is A, and this is alpha, and this is beta. So, then we can eliminate left recursion by replacing the pair of productions with. So, if it is in this format, then we need to convert into this format. Means, we'll take A tends to beta. Here, beta means small b, b and a dash. A dash here, a dash is the newly added non-terminal. Then, again, a dash tends to alpha. Alpha means capital B, a dash or epsilon. So, if they provided the production rule like A tends to A means capital A, capital B, or small b, then we say that this production rule is having left recursion problem. Then how we are going to eliminate? We eliminated with the help of these two productions. So I wrote capital A tends to small b a dash tends to capital B, capital A dash, or epsilon means null. So this is the way of converting, eliminating left recursion. So when you are converting the given context free grammar into Grayback normal form, first we need to check that whether it is in CNF or not, Chomsky normal form or not. Then after, you need to check that whether is it having any left recursions. If it is having any left recursion, then you need to eliminate. And then after, you check that whether the production rules are following the rules of GNF, means non-terminal tends to as a single terminal and the combination of non-terminals. So here now we discussed about how to eliminate left recursion. It is a very simple thing. So if any production rule is in this format, then we'll generate these two new productions. Now we discuss about an example how to convert the given context-free grammar into Grayback normal form. Here the example is S tends to XB or AA, A tends to small a or SA, B tends to small b, X tends to small a. When you observed this grammar, first you need to check that whether it is in CNF or not. CNF means it should have in which format? Non-terminal tends to string of exactly two non-terminals. Non-terminal tends to single terminal. If any grammar in this format, we say that it is in CNF. So when you observe this example, so it is in CNF, simply we say that. And second point is whether is it having any left recursions. So left recursion is nothing but the LHS side of non-terminal should not contain rightmost of RHS side. Here S tends to XB or AA. So it is not having any left recursion. A tends to A, yes, A. It is also don't have any recursions. B tends to B, X tends to A. These two are already in GNF. Now we need to concentrate on this one, and this one, these three things. So already the given grammar is in CNF and there is no left recursion. So when you observe that A tends to SA, A tends to SA, it is not in GNF. So we need to convert it is possible of GNF. So what we'll do here, S is there. S tends to XB AA. We'll replace with that one in S. So then we say that we can substitute S of XB AA in the production rule A of SA. Then what we get? S tends to XB AA is already existing one, and A tends to A. So second one is SA. SA. S is having the production XB and A will be there. AA and A will be there. And the remaining two productions are same. So this is the new production rules which is generated after trying to modify A tends to SA. But when you observe here, A tends to AAA, A tends to AAA. So it is having left recursion, but we'll discuss later on. First we discuss about remaining things. So the production rule S tends to XB and B tends to XBA is not in GNN. So what we'll do? We'll substitute X tends to A in production rule. So we'll get S tends to AB, AA, A tends to A, ABA, AAA, B tends to B, X tends to A. So when observe here, S tends to AB, it is in GNF. A tends to A is also GNF. A tends to ABA is also GNF. B tends to B and X tends to A also GNF. So finally, we got these production rules. Now we concentrate on left recursion. Already we found that A tends to AAA is there. So it is left recursion. So in previous slide, we discussed about how to remove the left recursion. We can follow that process or else we have another method. So here we'll introduce a new variable to remove the left recursion in place of A and replace with a new variable with and without new variable only. For example, so A tends to AAA is there. I am going to introduce a new variable called C. So that I am going to apply in this production rule. So S tends to AB, AA, it is okay. When it comes to A tends to A. So what we need to do, we need to remove that one. For that, what I am doing is, I am adding a new variable and without new variable, I am doing with new variable and without new variable. So I am concentrating with these two things only, A and ABA. So AC, I am adding C. ABA, C, I am adding C. With, and second is without, means A, ABA. And C, which is already we implemented, means which is a new variable which we added, it will be with and without, same like that. C tends to AAC and AA. So this is the way which we can remove the left recursion. When you observe now, A tends to AAA is there, but we removed the left recursion. So for remove left recursion, simply what we did? The production rules which is having with A tends to, excluding AAA, whatever the new variable which are going to add, will apply on that one with and without. So when I exclude AAA, I am having A tends to A is there and A tends to ABA is there. So include, exclude. If this is assumed excluding, including is not what? It will come. So when I included additional variable C, it will come. Excluding means it will not come. So that we applied here. And whatever the new variable which we applied will be same like that. C tends to AA and AAC with and without. So now when you observe this grammar, we don't have any left recursions. S tends to AB, AA. A tends to AC, ABAC, AABA. C tends to AAC, AA. B tends to B, X tends to A. Now, we need to check that whether these production rules are in GNF or not. A tends to AB is GNF, but this is not. A tends to AC, ABA, AABA, it is totally GNF. C tends to AAC and C tends to AA, not in GNF. So, these three are not in GNF. Now, we need to try to remove. We need to try to convert this one into GNF. So the production rule S tends to AA and C tends to AA not in GNF. So we substitute A in AA and here. So what is the production rule of A? this is the production rule for A. A tends to AC, AB, AC, A, AB, A. So, I am substituting one A with the total production. Then what will get? S tends to. So, when absolute S tends to AB, AB is there, AB. Next, S tends to AA. Now, I am substituting one A with A tends to AC like that. So, what will get? AC, another A, AB, AC, another A, another A, AB, A, another A. Same like that, C tends to AA also. So, I am having C tends to AA. I am substituting with one A with this one. So, I got A, CA, A, CA, AB, ACA, AA, AB, AA. So, ACA, AB, ACA, like that. Then B tends to B, X tends to A, it is common. Once I am repeating the previous steps. So, this is the grammar which we got. S tends to AB, AA, A tends to A, AB, A, AA, A, B tends to B, X tends to A. We need to, this is an example. A tends to A, SA, B tends to B, X tends to A. We need to check that whether the grammar is having any left recursions. And one more thing is it in CNF? Yes, it is in CNF and you don't have any left recursions. But the grammar is not in GNF. Why? Due to the productions. So, I observed that first I took one production rule, A tends to SA. So, what I did? A tends to SA. So, I substituted S in A. So, I got this production rule. And then after, S tends to XB and B tends to XBA. I observed that S tends to XB and A tends to XBA. Sorry, this is A. So, it is not in GNF. So, we substitute X with A. So, what we got? S tends to AB, AA. A tends to A, AB, AA. So, here XB, XBA is replaced with small AB, small ABA. Why? Because with the help of this production rule. And now, we identify one left recursion, A tends to AAA. So, already in previous slide, we discussed how to remove the left recursion. So, instead of that, what we are doing is, we are going to create a new variable, new non-terminal, and whatever the production rule is available on remaining A, will apply that one with and without. So, with a new variable and without new variable. Then we got this one. Means the remaining productions are A tends to AC, A tends to ABA. So, with new symbol and without new symbol, we added. Means AC, AC and ABAC. This is with new symbol. Without is A, ABA. And the new symbol C tends to same with C and without C. AAC, AA. So, this is a way of removing the left recursion. And another we identified S tends to AA and C tends to AA. This is also not in GNF. Then what we did is, we substituted A with the production rules. Whatever the A we having, we substituted with the production rule of this one. So, we got these production rules. And after that, we identified that A tends, C tends to ASC. I think this is only the production rule which is not in GNF. So, rule C tends to ASC is not GNF. So, we substitute A. We we substitute A in the production rules to AAC. Same what we did in previous step, I am doing. So, this A will be replaced with this all. So, C tends to AAC will be AC, 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 AB, AC, AC, A, AC, AB, A, AC. And remaining two, C tends to ACA, AB, ACA, AA, ABA, A, B tends to B, X tends to A. Remaining all same. Now, when you observe the grammar, here everyone is in CNF and don't have any left recursions and in GNF also. So, this is the way of converting the given grammar into GNF. So, should keep in mind that simply you need to check that whether it is in grammar in CNF or not. If it is CNF, then we need to check that whether it is having any left recursions. So, left recursions, if you find any left recursions, blindly you say that you go with addition of new variable, and where you found, in which production rule you found the left recursion, that may having another terms. So, by adding a new variable and without new variable will generate the production rules. So, in this example, so I found A tends to A, ABA, AAA. Here, this is the left recursion. What I did is, I removed that one. I removed that one. And what I did is, I implemented a new variable like C. And that C is added to existing these two terms. Adding and without also. And C tends to AAC and AA. Means same we applied. So actually my intention is C tends to AAA. So but we can't go with directly AAA. That's why whatever we included a new variable and without new variable, I designed production rule. So this is the way of converting the given grammar into GNF. So, the students, just to go through with this example and convert this grammar into GNF. It's a very simple thing. We have only two things. So, first thing, whether it is in CNF or not. Yes, it is in CNF. Is it having any left recursion? No, it doesn't have a left recursion. So, we'll start the process. But at the demo starting process, you may find the left recursions, but you need to convert it. Okay. So, just try to convert and find the solution for this one. Okay. So, today we will wind up the class, and tomorrow we will discuss new topic.